fight the world, I fight you, I fight myself. I fight God, just tell me how many burdens left. I fight pain and hurricanes, today I wept. I'm trying to fight back tears, flood on my doorsteps. Life a living hell, puddles of blood in the street. Shooters on top of the building, government aid ain't relief. Earthquake, the body drop, the ground breaks. The poor run with smoke lungs and scarred face. Who need a hero?
Hero.
You need a hero, look in the mirror, there go your hero. Who on the front lines at ground zero?
Hero.
My heart don't skip a beat even when hard times bumps the needle.
I have here with me the one and only
D1, you know
D1, what it is. Mission Vision.
Yeah, Mission Vision.
Be real, be righteous, be relevant.
Slingshot David album out right now, all that there.
All right, so tell us a little bit about the new album.
Yeah, the brand new album, Slingshot David, man. You know, this the biggest album of my career. Just put it out. Just won Hip Hop Album of the Year by Offbeat Magazine.
Awesome.
Just got off a nationwide tour, the Slingshot David tour, all around the country. Like, it's great. People loving it. Just dropped a new single featuring 7 Streeter called Love Always Wins. The music video just came out, so we good. It premiered on BET today.
Awesome. That's really, really dope. So I also see that you're also doing a lot of speaking engagements. I also saw you hosting, doing what I'm doing on the red carpet for BET. I was like, look at D1.
Yes. All I can say is God is good. God is blessing you, boy. So whether it's hosting, speaking, rapping, like, I'm just using my slingshot.
Right.
That's all it boiled down to. I'm using my slingshot to defeat my Goliath. You heard me?
I also heard it was a YouTube that you had up. You spoke at a church, and that was a really deep message. That was really, really, really awesome.
Thank you. You know.
I gave a testimony.
I gave a word. When God give me the word, I'm being selfish if I don't give it to the people. So when God give it to me, I got to give it to the people.
Awesome, awesome. So can you let us know like how to find you on social media?
Yeah, look, y'all can find me on social media at D1 Music, D-E-E, the number one music. Follow the journey, D-E-E, the number one music. Let's get it.
So I have to ask you, what does Black Panther and tonight mean for you? I mean, you have we all have on the African attire. Everyone is looking really nice. We have the black magic going on.
Yeah, it's honestly, this a moment in history right now, and I'm thankful I'm alive for it, you know what I mean? We gotta stick together, we gotta show our black excellence, and we doing all that tonight at this premiere. So I'm excited, man. Like, I don't even watch Marvel movies.
What?
I'm not even gonna lie to you.
Me either.
I don't watch them. But I'm here, yeah.
Yes. Well, I want to thank you so much, D1. I love everything you're doing. I love your movement. I've been following you for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And I really, really, really want to thank you for stopping by and talking with us.
Appreciate
and
you, Quinn.
Definitely would love to talk to you again.
Love. You already know.
We are live back at the Black Panther premiere in New Orleans. This is your girl, Ari B, and I'm here. I have Mr. Ruben with me.
How y'all doing? What's going on?
All right, Mr. Ruben. So tell us a little bit about yourself and your music, because I hear that you're an artist.
I'm a visual artist. I'm a painter. Yeah, I paint portraits.
Awesome.
Yes, ma'am.
So can you tell us what's your inspiration behind your portraits?
Most of the stuff that I do is like live painting at concerts and stuff like that, like events like this, so associated with different events that are going on in the community.
Okay, awesome. So while the event is going on, your painting is
right,
the event.
Right.
That's pretty cool. That's really dope. Awesome. So how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing this in New Orleans for about 4 years.
4 years?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, can you tell us how can we reach you if anyone's interested in getting in contact with you?
I'm on Instagram, R Cheatham Artist. It's my first initial and last name, R-C-H-E-A-T-E-M Artist, the word.
Okay. Well, we see you are looking really fly tonight for the event. Can you tell us what you're looking forward to seeing tonight with the movie?
Oh man, it's just good to see the kids out so excited about seeing this, and you know, to see the black faces on the screen like this, like they need to, just to see us in position of power and just, you know.
So tell me a little bit about what are you doing with Juan Lafonta?
So right now Juan is working with artists, doing some billboards around the city. He's kind of innovative with it, using like original artwork rather than just, you know, the standard billboard advertisement. So I'm one of about 6 or 7 artists that did an original painting for him that's going to be going up in billboards around the city.
Okay, so have you worked with him on any previous projects that's out? Because I know I've seen a lot of his billboards around the city.
Yeah, well, I actually just connected with Juan about 2 months ago for this project specifically. A mutual friend introduced us and got us hooked up together. So, yeah, I'm glad that he chose me for it.
Okay, so what can we look to see that around? Is it going to be like a billboard or is it something?
There's one that's up. It's by the same artist that did the poster for this Black Panther Party event, Black Panther movie. And I think that's going to be up for about 5 or 6 more months, and then like they'll be going up sporadically from all the other, myself and other 5 artists.
So let us know, how does the creative process behind the scenes go? Like, how do you come up with the innovation? Does he like give you certain ideas, or he's just kind of...
Yeah, he had a vision, and there was also requirements to make it fit the code of what the city would accept as an advertisement. So we had to integrate that into the art, you know, artistically. But yeah, he had a vision, and so it was good to, you know, bring that to life.
Hey everyone, so we're back live at the Black Panther premiere with Mr. Juan Lafonta, and I have Miss Deepa here with me.
Hey, how are you doing? New Orleans, what's happening?
All right, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and what it is that you do? Because I'm loving this outfit.
Oh, well, this outfit was designed by New Orleans local Kino Couture, Kino Watson. And I'm actually...
Stop?
Okay, yeah.
Yes, we have to catch this. Okay.
All right. Yeah. So I'm actually Deepa Soul, and I have an orchestra. We call Deepa Soul and the Love Soul Orchestra. I came home from New York and did a live album at the Carver before it closed. And I'm excited. We're going to go out with the album on tour in 2019.
Awesome. So do you have any also upcoming work coming up, or any other songs that like previously that are out?
Oh, I did previous songs. I actually do EDM music as well, electronic dance music, or house music, they call it. I've been on Billboard charts, did my whole thing. But I do funk, rock, and soul music with my live orchestra. So that is me getting back to my roots and coming back home to New Orleans. And the album is called Creole Woman. That's the album.
So are there any artists in the city or anybody else that we would know who you work with?
Yeah, Gigi Pinder actually is all. She came live on stage with me, yeah. So we're going to, we have a collab on a single coming up too with her.
Okay, so if anybody wants to hear your music, how can we find it? Like, what's your social media?
Deepa Soul, DEEPASOUL.com. That's
okay,
it.
Okay, so let us know about tonight. What are you expecting to see tonight? How has your experience been so far, like seeing all the different costumes?
Oh, I mean, this is such an amazing and a wonderful opportunity for African Americans in the industry. Being creative industry professionals, it's so important that we support each other. And I'm so excited to see all the different people come out dressed in all the different outfits. And we're in Wakanda right now. We're here. Yes. Fabulosity, I love it.
Okay, well, I want to thank you so much for stopping by. It was nice meeting you. You look fly. Right. I look
thank
forward
so
to talking
much.
With you again.
All right.
Hey, what's up, everyone? We're back. We're live at the Black Panther movie premiere. I'm here with Mr. Donnie Stice.
How y'all doing? I'm just here. This is a beautiful thing, and I'm loving everything by Juan Lafonta, what he put together. Bought tickets for the kids, for everyone to watch this movie. I am blessed to be a part of this movie, to where I was the private chef for all the cast, for Lupita Nyong'o, for Michael B. Jordan, for Winston Duke, for Daniel Kaluuya, for Denaya, everybody. So I'm here in New Orleans welcoming this movie to my city, to where it's a great movement, you know?
Now, how awesome was that filming? I mean, how awesome was that working and working with all of those amazing actors? Were you nervous a little bit about?
Nah, it's just that I was bringing New Orleans to them. Everybody from around the world love our food. So basically what I was doing, I was just bringing that to them, to where they loved everything. And it made me comfortable because, you know, it was black excellence all the way around. And it was nervous at first meeting Black Panther, which was Chad Bozeman. I'm sorry, I forgot to mention him. And after that, me and him got cool. So it's like I give great gratitude to Michael B. Jordan, who brought me in for cooking for everybody. So I'm
also Michael B. Jordan, the actor?
Yes.
Wow, that's not how did you meet him? How did that come about?
I met him through a childhood friend, Corey Collier. He the one brought me around, and he helped me get along the way and getting the opportunity for it.
That's really awesome, because I know Michael's been here before working on a couple of films in New Orleans. Yeah, and he's another great actor also. Really, really awesome. So can you tell us how long have you been cooking? What was the inspiration?
For 4 years. So it's just like I did a lot of things, to where I made a lot of moves outside the city, even though I always gave back to the city. And a handful of people always, you know, ate some of my food. But other than that, I'm blessed for the opportunity for reaching out. And I really basically give the credit to my mom, also my manager, Tony Flott, who helped me out, and everybody who supported me. So this is a great movie. I want everybody to watch it. It makes you feel like a king and a queen all over
again.
Yes,
and everybody just looks so awesome. We're all dressed up really nice,
like,
in a black
pants.
I mean, we have so much black magic walking around here and swirling around here. It's really, really awesome. So can you tell us how we can reach you on social media, your handles, if anybody want to get in contact
with you? You can reach me at Donnie Stice at 22. I'm sorry, DonnieStikes22@gmail.com. Also, you can reach me on Instagram at DonnieStikes. Everything is basically DonnieStikes.
Okay.
So that's how you can find me.
All right. Well, I want to thank you so much. And I'm going to have to take you up one day, you know, because I love to eat. All right. So thank you so much for stopping by. And I look forward to talking with you again.
Thank you.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank God. I know people say that all the time on TV, but it's really important for you to understand that God's in control of all things. So I give glory to God first. Let me explain to you little kids why you're here today. Everybody try to tell my story. I'm going to tell my story for me.
Come on.
Okay. First of all, I'm not Mexican.
Okay? Yeah, you Mexican.
I know y'all going to laugh on that. Everybody always asks me, to say, well, you black? Are you white? Are you purple? You green? You red? What? I'm black. Born and raised in the 7th Ward. I'm a hard head. Okay?
That's right.
And I got to where I got today from that neighborhood that raised me. From those parents in the neighborhood, from those people that fed me when we didn't have food, the people that loaned us chicken grease to fry chicken and Kool-Aid to make Kool-Aid. And it's so important for y'all to know that no matter how bad your situation is, no matter how bad things look around you, and no matter what you've been through, that God has a plan and you can make a difference. Because I ain't come from no background where everybody was paid and everybody's privileged and we all walking in. We had to save our stuff to make it. And I got my neighbors in my community here and their kids they brought in here because each one's gonna teach one and we're gonna reach forward. So I did this because it's time that black folks in the community that have money put the money back into the community. And all of y'all that heard Jay-Z's song, why am I going to buy Belvedere when Puffy got Ciroc? So we need to start patronizing our community. And last but not least, and I'm going to go because I don't want to do no long speeches. I want y'all to understand this. Black is beautiful. It ain't dark skin. It ain't light skin. It ain't beige. It ain't brown. It's just black. No matter how you look at it. And when you start to travel and look around, you will see our people are everywhere. And they are leaders in this community. They come from strong history. They're intelligent. Don't believe what the news is putting on that our people represent. That is not our people. Okay? When you look around this room and see people hugging people, and a brother who mentored me from Teen Summit up here holding hands together, that's what this community is about. All right? So don't y'all forget it, and when y'all in the position I'm in, make sure y'all take some kids to the movies. God bless.
Yeah. And then I had the opportunity to go and speak at the Youth Study Center for Kids Juveniles. And as I talked to them, I told them that they've got to make a decision. There's only two teams. Brother Winnie told me that next month they're drafting for the NFL. I'm here to tell you young people, and I want you to hear me well. They're not for two teams, God's team and the devil's team. The devil's team is already forfeited. But God said, you better hurry and get on this team. How many of you love God? Raise your hand. If you love him, then we have to start serving. Now do something for me, and I'm going to get out of your way. If you love God, turn to the person next to you and say, God loves you. No, that's not good enough. No. I know you eat your popcorn, but there will come a time. Turn to the person and say, God loves you. And so do I. And give him a big hug. I want you to sit and enjoy this move, because it shows you what black excellence is all about. Will you give Brother Juan another round of applause? Thank you, thank you, thank you.